Start by telling us a bit about your character in All-Stars, Ethan.
Cheers, that's kind. And Ethan, yeah, well, he's at first he likes to think of himself as being a bit cool, a bit of a big man. But as the story unfolds, you really figure out that he's just trying to fit in like everyone else. And he's really passionate about something, which he's got in common with a lot of the other characters.
What excited you about the film overall?
The dancing, mainly, because that's something I've always wanted to try professionally. And also just such a heartwarming, endearing script. And yeah, just really, really hit home, do you know what I mean? So yeah.
You're working with some great choreographers in this film. What kind of dance moves are we going to get to see?
The best. But yeah, dance moves, the Dougie, maybe a backflip. Yeah.
Obviously, the kind of dance films are a big craze at the moment. What do you think distinguishes All-Stars? What makes it special and sets it apart from other films like that?
I've been thinking about it a lot recently, actually, and it's definitely got a lot more heart. You really get to see more deeper into the characters' lives, and yeah, it's just got more comedic characters in it, which you can really relate to. Yeah.
Working with some very funny older actors as well, people like Ashley Jensen. What have you learned from people like that?
Well, I've learned a lot, and Ashley Jensen is lovely as well, but Kevin Bishop, who plays my dad, really had a lot in common with him, because he's been acting since from about my age, so he had a lot of advice to give, and yeah, so definitely a true pal. Yeah.
The film's clearly a fun ride, but it does touch on some sort of serious issues as well, do you think?
Yeah, it definitely does, such as Ethan, you know, my character, his mum and dad aren't together, and he's going through quite a tough time at home. And Fleur, who plays Amy, she's helping look after her dad, who's suffering from depression. So it's quite a touchy subject, as well as, you know, the glitz and the glam and the jazz hands. You know. Yeah.
Are there any particular scenes that you're especially proud of?
Yeah, I mean, the dancing, obviously, that's something we worked a long time for, so it was great to, you know, have it paid off. But also some more intimate scenes and subtle scenes, such as a scene with Kevin Bishop that I do, which I'm quite proud of. And just things like that, you know, getting to work with people like him is just such an honour and privilege.
Talking about work, what's coming up next for you?
Coming up next, well, nothing definite at the moment, but hopefully I'm going to work with Akai again soon. He's got some plans, I know that. And hopefully do some more theatre, because I like to think of that as my roots, and it's something that I'd like to get back to as soon as possible, really. But I've also got quite a lot of schoolwork, but it's not going to stop me. I mean, I do what I love, so.
Fans are going to want to know Horrid Henry, of course, a big success. Are we going to get to see any more Horrid Henry films?
I'm afraid not from me. I mean, not yet. I think I've grown up quite a lot in the last 3 years, so it's been a little while, but yeah. Thanks.
What are you hoping that audiences are going to take away from this film when they get a chance to see it?
Well, they can definitely walk out with a smile on their face. I mean, I think like you said, it's different from other street dance movies, because there's something in there for everyone, not just it's a whole wide range of ages that can enjoy it and appreciate it, which is different. I mean, there's loads of different dance styles, and there's songs in there, and yeah, and like I said, some familiar faces. So.
You mentioned working with Akai there. Obviously, he's a fantastic young dancer. What was he like to work with, and how impressed were you with his moves?
Oh, I'm impressed with everything he does. I mean, like, he's generally a true best mate of mine, and. And yeah, and like, he obviously helped me a lot out with the dancing whenever I needed some help. And I like to think I was there for him if ever he needed help with acting, which he didn't, but yeah.
Final question, do you have a message for fans before you leave? Is there anything you'd like to say to them?
My message would be that you should take opportunities when they're in front of you, not wait around for anything better to come along, because, you know, it might not happen, and that's something that's become very real for me in the past couple of years. So yeah.
Enjoy yourself tonight. Congrats on the film. Fantastic to have you tonight. Can you start by telling us a bit about your character in the film?
Well, my character, Jaden, you know, he's a shy kid. He has an absolute passion for dance, and he's just a lovable character, you know? Yeah.
Clearly, you share that passion for dance. What do you love about dance so much, and what does this character get from it?
You know what? Me and Jaden, you know, we do have some similarities, but we do have a few differences. But we both have the same passion for dance, you know. We just feel free when we're dancing. It allows us to express ourselves in a way that we can't do if we're doing other, you know, leisure activities. So, yeah.
Of course, we've seen a lot of you dancing before, but what are we going to see from this film that we maybe haven't seen from you before?
You're going to see, you know, from my dancing, yeah? From my dancing, you're going to see a few new tricks, a few new moves I've been filling up my sleeve, you know, I've been waiting to get out there. And just a different style to Jaden and to Akka as well, both of our characters, yeah.
For fans who haven't seen the film yet, can you just give us a quick synopsis? What's All Stars all about? What's the story?
What's the story? The story is about two guys that are completely different from each other, but for different reasons, they join forces to save their local youth centre, also known as the Garage, which is in threat of being closed down. Yeah.
You're working with some great older performers as well, people like Ashley Jensen. What have you learned from working with actors like that?
Working with actors like Ashley Jensen and Ashley Walters, they just gave me loads of advice, like just try and stay in character whenever you're on set. Even when the camera's off, try and stay in character, you know. Just little tips here and there that will help me, and I will definitely keep on thinking about and trying to improve whilst I'm still in the entertainment business.
You're a very busy man. You've always got lots on the go. Apart from this film, what else is going on at the moment? Clothing line, music, what's that?
Yeah, I've got a clothing line. I had a clothing line since I won Got to Dance, so that's not quite new yet. That's not new, really. About a year ago, I was signed to Warner Chappell for my debut album. So you're going to, and a few TV programs I've got lined up. So you're definitely going to be seeing me on TV much more.
What's the album going to sound like?
The album, it's got every single genre, literally, you know. It's got pop.
Greedy.
I just want to show off my versatility. I want to show off all of my talents, you know.
And have you been collaborating with anyone in particular on that?
I have, but I've got to keep it on a down low, you know. Yeah, I've got to keep, hush, hush, yeah.
Are you going to tour it? Are we going to see you live performing?
Definitely going to see me live performing that. Hopefully, the objective, by the end, maybe midway of next year, I'll be doing my own tour, doing my music, you know.
Final question, do you have a message for fans before you leave us, all the people who love and enjoy your stuff so much?
Yes, I want to thank all my fans for supporting me. You've been there from the beginning, you know, from Got to Dance, and just keep on being an act star and just keep on supporting me. I know you guys are going to go far, and I hope you believe in me the way I believe in you guys as well. So thank you for supporting me. Thank you.
I play Akai's dad, Mark, Jaden's father, I should say. Quite a strict father. Wants his son to stay in school and go to a good private school, go to college and uni like most parents do. But he has a dream to follow, and eventually I have to let him follow the dream, basically. Pretty much, you know, every story between every father and son at some point.
Of course, you're working with a little superstar in Akai. What was he like to work with?
He's a huge superstar. He's not a little superstar, obviously, in size.
I meant physically.
Size, yeah, cool. But, yeah, he's amazing, man. It's like, his performance is flawless. We're shooting on 3D and stuff like this, and like one taking it all the time, putting me to shame, basically. So I really have to step up my game. He's a very, very confident young man, and I believe he's going to go really, really far. You know, there's loads of elements that go to it, but I think, you know, the passion for these movies is more about seeing people in the beginning when they're the underdog and how they come through that, how it makes them grow, how it matures them, and who they become at the end. And I think all the characters have a journey in this movie, which loads of people are going to be able to relate to. It's kind of like, you know, the Goonies, Flight of the Navigator, Stand By Me, that whole vibe is what makes people come and see these films and love them. I love Street Dance, and I think everyone's going to love All Stars. I haven't seen it yet myself, but it should be the first time tonight, but I think it's going to be amazing. It always is.
What else have you got coming up at the moment?
Doctor Who's coming on Friday, I think, Wednesday. And just finished shooting Top Boy 2, which will be out later this year. And I'm about to shoot another two TV series, one called Musketeers and one called Truckers. And then I'm doing a bit of directing later on this year, hopefully. I've just finished directing a short of my own as well, so I'm just editing that at the moment.
Much there to talk about, but I guess the first thing Who fans are going to want to know, what was it like working with Matt Smith and, of course, the wonderful new companion, Jenna?
They're gods to me now. It's a hard job, Doctor Who. I think, you know, it looks flawless when you watch it, but Matt and Jenna, they have to do a lot of work, put in a lot of work for that, and they kind of guided me through. Matt's amazing to work with. I spent most of my time filming with him, and the character, you know, he's so down to earth and so humble, and he's been doing it for so long, but he's an amazing guy, man. I learned a lot from working with him. I'd love to do it again, so when you're ready, I'm ready.
I play Gina, who runs the youth centre that the kids all go to that has been threatened with closure. And she single-handedly is fighting to keep this youth centre, community centre open. I think she realises how vital things like that are within the community, which is what, you know, I think sort of sets this film apart a wee bit, that it's no, it's not just a family film that's fun with a great soundtrack, and it makes London look really good, and it makes it look like it was sunny all last summer, which is a feat in itself. But it's got a real heart to it, and you know, I suppose like living in the world at the moment with all these things that are being threatened with closures and stuff like that, so it's pointing up the how essential things like that are.
You've got so much fun stuff coming up, a new ITV show, and I think a Gnomeo and Juliet sequel based on Sherlock. Sherlock Gnomes, can you tell us anything about that?
You know about as much as I do. They just got in touch with me and said, would you be up for it? And I was like, of course I would. Yeah, lovely.
And what about the ITV TV show that you do?
That's called Love and Marriage, which is a six-part family drama about the three sort of generations of family. There's the older generation and their children, and then all the husbands and wives, and then all our children.
Wait to see all of that, and thank you so much for talking to us.
Well, I play the lead character Theo. I play his mother, Trish. Yes, a mother to a 12-year-old. It's a bit of a shock to the system, but yeah, that's
a lot of makeup involved.
Possible. I wish. But no, I know Theo because we worked together before on Horrid Henry, and it was actually really a big help. I think that I already knew him, and we could kind of fall quite naturally into that, you know, mother-son role. Hopefully we did a good job. We'll see. We'll soon find out.
You've taken the dancing world by storm on Strictly. You were just so fantastic. Do you bring out any moves in this movie?
Do you know what? It was before Strictly, sorry. So I'm sure if it had come after Strictly, they'd have been like, oh, maybe there's a bit where Trish, the mother, gets up and does a cha-cha-cha. But no, it didn't happen. But they've done some amazing 3D dance films lately, and this is incredible. I would have loved to have been a part of the dancing, but no, I got to watch it all on set every day, so that was good.
Of course, I think fans are also very excited to hear that we're going to have your autobiography soon. What made it the right time for you to do that now, and what are fans going to get to read about in that they maybe might be surprised by?
And do you know what? It just feels like the end of the sort of first chapter of my life, and I felt like it was the perfect time to kind of, yeah, do a bit of a roundup. And yeah, it's just going to be as honest as I can possibly be. So whether or not people will find my side of the story interesting, we'll have to wait and see. They kept us really entertained on set as well, because if you had like a few hours and you're bored, then they started just busting to choreography, and you know, you've got like a full street dance show to the left of you, which was quite entertaining. And actually they're so amazing, like they're really brilliant actors, especially obviously Theo, who I worked with mainly in the film. You know, he's played lead before in Horrid Henry, and I'd met him before, so we kind of had that advantage, I guess, because we already knew each other, so we had that chemistry, but it was good fun.
Working with such a nice brood.
I have got so many babies around me at the moment, friends, family, my sister's expecting again, which is really exciting, so I'm going to be an aunt to the second one. I feel like I can just look after everybody else's for now, because I'm a little bit busy to have one myself, but I do, yeah, I love kids. Hopefully it's something I'm definitely going to do in the future.
Do any more films after this?
I would like to do more acting. Yeah, I feel like I've only kind of dipped my toes back in at the moment. And yeah, I'm kind of still looking at other roles, and yeah, hopefully there'll be something out there that I can really get my teeth into. So we'll see.
My character is Kurt. He plays the bad guy of the movie. A little bit of a bully towards the main character. And yeah, he owns a crew called Cybernetics, which do a lot of amazing routines.
Is it fun to play a bad guy? And were there any particular experiences of your own that you drew upon to play a bully?
Well, to be honest, I'm a happy-go-lucky Asian, so playing a bully was just not me at all. Like, it's the exact opposite of me, because I'm not usually that mean anyway, but in dance, it helps your persona. So to be able to play a bad guy, it actually helped my dance even more. And I really enjoyed it because it was different for me.
In terms of the dancing, what kind of styles of dancing do we get to see specifically from you in this?
Well, you're going to see a lot of finger magical stuff, a lot of popping and hip-hop.
Why do you think that suited your character specifically?
Well, to be honest, the leader is the leader of cybernetics. So cybernetics kind of makes you think robots or like some kind of animation stuff. So that's what it is, really.
What do you think fans are going to take from the film overall?
I hope they can be inspired, most of all, because I get inspired by the last two street dance films, and hopefully they'll be inspired by this street dance film. So that's what I want from them.
Clearly, street dance is exploding as a global phenomenon. Why do you think that is? Why do people all around the world seem so excited about it right now?
I think it allows the kids to be themselves in a different way, and it's just a nice way of expressing yourself, really.
My character in All Stars is called Tim. He's a typical kind of stereotypical, well, on the outside, he looks like a stereotypical kind of Chelsea, like, posh boy, like, very guarded security life, and he doesn't seem to want much out of life apart from just kind of, he's very dull, but on the outside he seems to, and then when you look more into him, he seems to have a big heart, and he seems to really care about what he's doing and his friends, and trying to get out of the routine he has of just following his sister about and doing what she does.
Was it easy to prepare for the role? Did you base it on anyone in particular?
There was a few people in my school who I used as slight inspiration, but no one in particular, really.
What excited you about the role and being involved in the film overall?
Well, first of all, I thought it was really funny, and I was lucky to have a lot of what I think are funny lines in the film. I thought I was lucky I got good lines. The character was just a lot of fun to play. Like, there wasn't any really serious like stuff in it. It was just kind of fun, witty kind of stuff, which was nice.
Of course, there's some great dance moves in the film. Do you have any of your own to show off in this film?
Well, I wouldn't call myself an amazing dancer at all, but I had a lot of good choreographers to work with, and they helped a lot to make me look a better dancer than I am. So yeah.
Are there any particular moves that they taught you that you think you're going to use now that you've learnt them?
I don't know. I'm still a bit wary of using them out and about at the moment, but maybe if I practice a bit, I'll be able to use them around the place, I guess.
Are you doing anything else after this? Have you got any other work lined up?
Not anything planned, just carry on with my school and going to college and stuff, really. That's about it.
What made you want to tell this story in particular?
I kind of grew up skateboarding, and when I wouldn't work hard enough at school, which was always, my dad would take my skateboard away, and so I couldn't skate, and I'd just feel completely repressed and think about skateboarding all the time, and that's kind of what the kid main character is about dancing. Like, he can't dance, he thinks about it all the time, and just the chance to tell that story visually and, you know, build weird sets and have samurai and lasers and just do a big funny movie. Kind of what it felt like as a kid to not be able to do what you want to do and have to fight to get to do it. I just wanted to make that film.
Of course, I mean, the film is big and it is fun, but there's also some serious issues kind of under the surface there. I mean, how important was it for you to include that kind of material?
Oh, yeah, really important. I mean, it's kind of like we got loads of anti-austerity stuff in there, just kind of, let's just tuck that in there and hope no one stops it. And you know, there's a coherent message about things are being taken away from people, and it's crazy, you know, and people have got to get together and do stuff about it and fight with their communities to protect their libraries, to protect their centres, and people are doing it, like Kensal Green Library, you know, they're all doing it themselves, doing their own library. It's just so inspiring, and it was that kind of thing really inspired me, and without wanting to be too preachy, just have the message there.
Of course, in order to tell that message, you need a good cast. Can you tell us a little bit about who we're going to see in the film and what made them right for the part?
Sure. Ashley Jensen is an amazing actor. I loved her in Extras, and she was the only and first choice for the film. And she's brilliant and amazing. John Barrowman's great. The kids are all great. Theo Stevenson, amazing actor. Akai, great dancer, great actor. Kimberly Walsh, of course, lovely lady, very down to earth. Lots of people gave us their time. And came to be in the film, and they were great, and it was an honour to work with them.
Of course, dance is a huge part of the film. What kind of styles are we going to see, and what are we going to see that we maybe haven't before in other dance films?
Street dance can be kind of quite a sterile thing when it's on film. It's like, what are you actually doing here? You're battling? What? How does that work? You know, I just wanted to dance more from the heart and stuff that I don't particularly know much about dancing, but our choreographers are amazing. Kenrick Sandy, who did the opening ceremony of the Olympics, and I would just say kind of blather gibberish to him about, oh, I want it to feel more like this, and he would just we'd find a way. So I feel like it's more from the heart. Like in the big dance sequence of Jaden Akai dancing on his own, he sits down in a chair halfway through and just has a breather and gets up again. Because that's what I thought it would be like if you danced on your own. And it feels like it's kind of more true, less performed, more what dance feels like. That's what I wanted to shoot.
Is there a particular scene that you're most proud of or most excited for people to see?
I like the origami scene when Jaden is writing in an exam that he doesn't want to do, and he climbs inside the exam paper and fights origami samurai. It's crazy and a sort of beautiful and odd, and shouldn't really be in a film like this, but works in the film and makes All Stars what it is, makes it the quirky, odds yet big, mainstream, feel-good film, you know, and just bring a bit of craziness to it.
What are you working on next? Have you got anything else in mind?
I'm doing two more films. I can't talk about them right now, but one's shooting in the summer and then one in the autumn or spring. And they're kind of for young audiences. They're bigger. One's big, one's small. And they're going to be both very loud and fun and heartfelt. Movies from the heart.
Final question. Do you have a message to fans about this film and why they should be rushing out to watch All Stars?
Come and see All Stars because it's loud. It will make you deaf, but won't hurt your eyes too much. The 3D doesn't burn your eyes. It's got a great soundtrack, great kids, it's fun and got heart. Please come. Yeah.